You can shoot it. Well, you're live on the internet, my friend.
Right now?
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus.
Okay,
back up. Matty, am I still doing the glass thing, or is your brother doing that? Okay. Now I can't say anything dirty anymore.
You could, but Dani won't be very happy with you.
Yeah.
No, don't put the lighter there. It's not a bong. Stop it. Ow.
Maybe I'll get a little closer to the hot action. But look how nice you guys look. Yeah, you're good. I'd like to welcome everyone to the Wang Aronson nuptials. See the groom, Mr. Wang, here right now. He's looking quite dapper, as we all know. If anyone has any questions, I won't be answering them. Do you think people can hear me if I talk on this? I don't even. I am, yeah. I don't know how it ended up being me. Okay, I'm probably fucking it up. Thank you for your support. They can hear me.
Whoa. Soul mask.
Thanks very much. I'll try and keep the witticisms coming.
Did Matty tell you about the glass?
I thought maybe his brother was going to do it now.
Okay, that's you, because his brother's going to be sitting over here with his daughter.
Okay, cool.
So it's sitting in a basket right here by the bench.
Okay.
Where you'll be standing.
Okay.
And it's going to be like at the very, very end after they bring out the hoopa.
So the last thing is I just hand him the glass.
You're going to take the glass and put it on the floor.
Okay.
And then they'll stand on it.
And I'll just
keep
filming the whole time.
Yeah.
Okay. Guys, I'm gonna smash the glass. It's gonna be sick. No, hand over the glass, not smash it. Yes, it is I, Jiggles. Matt Tracy, who let you on the internet? A lot of excitement, a lot of anticipation in the air.
Good call, Narcisa. Don't let him on the internet. Come the Wang parents. Gil and Susie looking lovely. And the man himself, dressed to the nines. Better believe he's got a pocket square. Wearing a jumpsuit.
For sharing their home with all of us for a pandemic reimagination of this wedding. We are here as a community against all odds. The world has stopped, revolutions have begun, and yet we're here in Brooklyn on this stoop.
Can you guys hear?
Dani's childhood stoop. To celebrate the love of these two amazing human beings. When you ask me to be your fake rabbi at Bamboo Garden, Brooklyn, Chinatown, it was truly the last thing I expected. As soon as you asked, I felt a heaviness in the pit of my stomach. Was it too many dumplings? Was it the dim sum catering hall wedding happening right next to us? Of course I said yes. After all, I have an all-encompassing couple crush on you guys. At your engagement party inside these very doors,
me too.
I held back tears after a mimosa or two. expressing how deeply excited I was for you both. And this goes way beyond any superficial words of congratulations. Back in January, when we had our first sit down, did not include this week. I was thrilled to meet for a drink at Long Island Bar. We waited in line on that church's evening. And after finally sitting down at our corner table, Dani left to use the bathroom. Just then, Matty leaned in and whispered, "I am so excited to marry her." And my heart leapt for you both. I felt like you were letting me in on some sort of wonderful secret. The truth is that my heart leaps for you both today. I am so honored to marry you, as your officiant, on your wedding day. I honestly cannot think of many people who are so well suited for one another, on paper, in the eyes of the Jewish people, but on a much more substantial level, I am so taken by you both as two strong souls who exist individually while simultaneously strengthening one another as a unit and officially today as a family. Like most couples these days, you met using a dating app. You matched on Bumble, which in Maddie's words is like Tinder, but gives more control to women or something. But you also matched up on a number of dating apps, so obviously there was something there. On your first date, you went to Matt's Fish, then Wilder, which Matty admits was a bit of a food guy flex. Matty was intimidated by how serious Dani was and by her do-gooder job at the ACLU. Dani thought Matty was kind of full of himself. Obviously got past these initial impressions, because Dani now described Matty as sensitive, smart, thoughtful, and passionate. Matty, you are someone who always tries to make everyone feel special, especially Dani. You are always in a bandana. Dani thinks your obsessive nail painting during quarantine is adorable, as is the fact that you cry during documentaries about female wrestling. You like to take care of people, but also love to challenge their ideas in order to encourage them to be the best version of themselves. Matty, you describe Dani as jubilant, sweet, beautiful, confident, excited, and excitable. Intelligent, caring, and the best person ever. Matty thinks of you as aware of who you are and what is right. You are someone with so much focus, drive, and kindness. Whenever Matty introduces you to new people, they all have the same response. She is the best. And they are absolutely right. We can see your hopeful optimism in the way that you describe Gumba as sweet. Despite the fact that he doesn't talk. You are always able to see people and things for who they are beyond words. My husband Max, who's photographing around here somewhere, had trouble picking out the perfect suit for her own wedding many moons ago. Something I'm sure Matty knows nothing about. I had to laugh because to me it was such a metaphor for marriage itself. How do you know that the person you choose, much like those suits, is the perfect person for you? Ultimately, you don't. And ultimately, there is no perfect. When you commit to marrying your partner, it is as an imperfect person. Marrying another imperfect person. You see their flaws. Hopefully, you love them more because of those flaws. And ideally, you make one another stronger in spite of those flaws. When I take these ideas into consideration, the thing that is most inspirational about you is that you both really see one another. I think that's the most alluring thing about you as a couple. While I know Howie and Judi know to the minute when you started dating, I know. It just seems like you've always been together. Like it was the most natural thing in the world. enthusiasm, both in general and for each other, is electric. Your unapologetic love of good food makes me want to learn how to cook. Just kidding. It does make me pine for a seat at your table, and more recently, this soup for leftovers. Now, while I could go on about you two crazy kids forever, it's really up to you, Dan and Matty, to share your intentions that will shape your marriage to one another. So, Danny, without further ado.
Matthew Scott Wang. The first time I recall us seriously discussing our marriage was at Key Sushi on Smith Street. It was around 2 years ago, and funny enough, we ran into Amy and Max at Key Sushi. They're very entwined in our couple. We spoke seriously of getting married. Maybe it was the sake, but that conversation started happening, and we discussed building a life together. You asked me if I wanted a traditional proposal, and as always, you delivered an experience that you knew would be special to me. We were in New Orleans for your birthday weekend. After a nice breakfast, a sunny walk, and a day exploring a museum, you proposed. I'm so happy to be in front of all our family, friends, and the internet declaring that's my us. Love for you. Because I'm a millennial, I love a listicle. So here are the things I most love about you in no particular order. You treat me like a queen, and you always cook me what I'm craving. You're not afraid to show your sensitivity and cry. You're always willing to put in the work to be the best version of yourself, and you motivate me to do the same. You're unafraid to challenge my ideas, you make me a stronger thinker, and you help me laugh at myself when I'm being a little bit silly. You've worked really hard to form a bond with my weird and grumpy cat Gumba. I like that he's had 2 mentions. I love that you always talk about us building a future together as a team. You care to create a positive and meaningful experience every time you do something together. Through good times, bad times, pandemic times, traveling the world times, hopefully one day, and for all time, I love you, Matty, my husband. Okay, that's okay.
I want more vows.
We did a surprise.
First time I remember thinking about a life together was in Baltimore. It's all trips. And you asked me, what's going on? Are you getting off the apps or what? And I said, Danielle, what are you doing? And I should have known then what I know now, that you are someone who is not and that's my preamble to my vows.
Okay.
So my vows to you, Danielle, is I vow to love you 100% of the time. About always ask if you're okay. But you know when I'm not.
Okay.
I gotta give you space. And Sundays. And Saturdays. I vow to let your joy and your generosity guide us our lives together. About to do all your nice work for you.
I'm trying.
About to never underestimate you. About to love you forever unconditionally. And I value that if the world gets too wild, that I'll hold you how much good it will get.
The groom is attempting to jump the gun. I report. groom attempting to jump the gun.
So, suits, the rings, please. My vows.
David Aronson passing the rings.
Listen, oh, no, the glasses. The glass.
Yeah. I think you I'm in charge of the glass.
Right now.
You got it.
And before we move forward, it's so important to take a moment to reflect on the past. So let's warmly remember Val Warnock, Grandma's Francis and Adele, Grandpa's George and Marty, Ruth and David, Aku and Ani. Mm. While they are not here physically, they're here in our hearts and in our minds. In a moment, you will place the rings on one another's fingers. Make sure you have them. Okay. Traditionally, we say, Hare at Mikudeshet Li. Or, with this ring, you are consecrated to me. While these words seem old and formal, the idea of something being kadosh or sacred is a stunningly beautiful concept. We hold what we choose to be sacred, and for you two, it's one another. So, Matty, you may place the ring on Daniel's finger and keep it there, hold on to it, and repeat after me. With this ring, you are consecrated to me. Danny, you may place the ring on Maddie's finger.
Hold your horses, Nora.
Hold it there. Repeat after me. With this ring, you are consecrated to me.
With this ring, you are consecrated to me.
I know you want to. Just a minute. You got it. Parents, this would be a great time to get that footler ready.
This way? Yeah. Okay, hold your arm in.
I'm okay.
Danny and Maddie, you may now walk down to the
Nora, I can confirm now that there will be a smooch.
Okay. Ready?
Mazel tov! L'chaim! report with some certainty from the scene that this is very, very cute and very beautiful. Gentlemen, I present the Aronson-Wangs.
Okay.
So we're
going to
let
Amy go,
yes.
I think.
Let's walk down to the park. Okay. Yeah, we're going to walk. Yeah. See you later. Okay. Woo! You guys, we did it. I guess they're out of here. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. So we assume they're going to come back at some point. Oh, they're coming back.
We're handing out free clothes and then I'm going to help everybody get souvenirs. So we're going to start from the end here, okay? And work our way this way. Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I present the Aronson-Wangs.
Give the wolf.
What is the, what do you do? I don't know, it's your wrestling thing.
You guys, that was beautiful.
We're married, internet.
They're married, you guys.
We're the Aronson-Wangs now.
And we're fucking married.
Deal with it.
Deal with it. Put that in your pipe and smoke it.
Nora was in a big hurry for the kiss. I told her to hold her horses. I don't know.
In the chat.
I don't know.
Nora in Boynton Beach.
We like your eagerness. It was very hard for us to wait as well.
You guys, that was beautiful.
We did it. What a crazy day.
Thank you for shooting. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, everyone, for attending. We loved having you all here.
Love you.
I've been rings. I've been your host, Jeremy Willis.
I was right. Secret.
Jeremy Willis.
I gave a lot of commentary.
Did you get your dinner?
I love you guys.
We have dinners for you.
Yeah.
We have